Conestoga, welcome to Campfire tonight. We're so glad you could join us. My name is Forget Me Not. I know I look like Mrs. Wilson and I sound like Mrs. Wilson, but I am not Mrs. Wilson. I'm a clone, and here's what has happened. Your real teachers have been whisked away into an underground secret laboratory where their memories have been imprinted and implanted in people like me, their clones. And then the real teachers have escaped anywhere they want to this week. So we are in charge, the clones are in charge. If you're wondering where the real Mrs. Wilson is this week, she has been invited to go to LA with Charlie and Dixie D'Amelio to become hopefully the next big famous TikToker. So we wish her good luck. So without further ado, we welcome you to Campfire, and I'm gonna go ahead and introduce the rest of the clones.
Conestoga students, I'm Beetle, the strongest animal in the world, by the way, look it up. Anyway, I'm Mr. Kramer's clone, and he can't be here. He's working at home. He's working on his latest invention, the electric sponge. He's hoping it's going to be a big seller. So I'm going to be here instead and taking care of you guys and enjoying virtual outdoor schooling. So let's have some fun.
Hi, I'm Trillium, named after the beautiful forest flower, not the lake. I'm Mrs. Nystrom's clone. She's off somewhere snorkeling with her son in Hawaii.
Hi, it's Mazama. I'm Miss Lewis's clone. I think Miss Lewis went to Croatia. She is hanging out on the beach playing in the turquoise water. So I look forward to seeing you at the campfire.
Hey, Conestoga sixth graders. Dragonfly here. Not really sure where Mrs. Sherman went. I just know that she went off the grid. She needed to get away from her kids just for a few days. She loves them, but being stuck in a house for that long, you can imagine, right? Anyways, I'm so excited to spend this campfire with y'all and know that Mrs. Sherman will be back.
Hi kids, I am Mrs. Catherall's clone, and my name is Mama Llama. Last I knew, she told me that she was gonna go off to Peru and raise some llamas on a farm. And so she is off snuggling with baby llamas and having fun in Peru. But never fear, Mama Llama is here, and we're gonna have a lot of fun in camp.
Well, hey, you guys. It's not actually Mr. Byrne. Mr. Byrne got locked out of his house again. Haven't seen him in a while, so take care of your pets. But I'm Sasquatcho. I'm excited for campfire with you guys. Let's do this.
Welcome, students, to Virtual Outdoor School. I am Calm Spirit. I've taken Mr. Fleming's place for this wonderful experience with you. I hope you enjoy it. Fleming's on a motorcycle cruise up in Canada. I look forward to this because he's spoken quite highly of you all.
Hey, Sasquatch!
Huh? Ooh, whoa! Hey, Beetle, catch! Whoa! Hey, Manzana, here.
Whoa. Calm Spirit, here you go.
Whoa. Dragonfly.
Whoa. Llama Llama. Ah, whoa. Trillium. Whoa. Forgive me not.
Whoa. Clones on three. One, two, three.
Whoa!
Thumbs up if you can hear
awesome.
Ms. Forget-Me-Not.
I was muted. Sometimes the clones aren't quite as bright as your real... Hey, we're so happy that you're here tonight and we can spend our first ever virtual campfire for Conestoga together. We're so excited. I've gathered a few friends here that maybe their faces look a little familiar. And we're going to get this show rocking and rolling. So first of all, there are two levels of appreciation that you can show tonight. One of them is a big loud clap. Go ahead and practice it. Ready, guys? Clap. Practice. Woo! Okay, the other level of appreciation is sort of a silent appreciation where you rub your hands together. Or you can kind of do this with your hands if you have a campfire behind you and it sort of lets the light reflect off your hands and shows your appreciation that way. And that will be our level of appreciation that we show a little later tonight. So without further ado, we're going to get this night kicked off and started with my friend Dragonfly, who looks a little bit like somebody you might know. And she's going to take it away with our first song of the night, Dragonfly.
It's Dragonfly. We're going to do a song, and it's going to be a Repeat After Me song, and also you're going to do some things with me, okay? And I have some helpers here with me, so we're going to stand back, and we're going to give it a go, all right? This is a Repeat After Me song.
This is a Repeat After Me song.
My mom gave me a penny.
My mom gave me a penny.
She said, well, go buy some candy.
She said, go buy some candy.
But I didn't buy any candy.
She said, I bought some bubblegum.
Bazooka, bubblegum.
My mom gave me a quarter. I didn't buy any water. I bought some bubblegum.
My mom gave me a dollar. She said go buy a collar. I didn't buy a collar. Instead, I bought some bubblegum.
Bazooka, bubblegum.
My mom gave me a bubblegum.
Bazooka, bubblegum.
All right, that was it for me. I am going to pass it on to Mama Llama, who has another song for us.
All right, we're going to sing Jellyfish. And this is how it goes. So hopefully you can see it. It is a Repeat After Me song.
Repeat After Me song.
Okay, can you hear me?
Yes.
Can you hear me?
Okay, this is a Repeat After Me song.
This is a repeat after me song.
And a do as I do song. And I'm standing. Everybody stand. Here we go. Arms up.
Arms up.
Arms up.
Wrists together.
Wrists together.
Jellyfish. Arms up.
Arms up.
Wrists together.
Wrists together.
Elbows together.
Elbows together.
Jellyfish.
Arms up.
Arms up. Wrists together.
Wrists together.
Elbows together.
Elbows together.
Knees together.
Knees together.
Jellyfish.
Jellyfish. Jellyfish. Jellyfish.
Arms up.
Arms up.
Wrists together.
Wrists together.
Elbows together.
Elbows together.
Knees together.
Knees together.
Feet together.
Feet together.
Jellyfish, 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 jellyfish.
Jellyfish, 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 jellyfish.
Arms up.
Arms up.
Wrists together.
Wrists together.
Elbows together.
Elbows together.
Knees together.
Knees together.
Feet together.
Feet together.
Head back.
Head back.
A jellyfish, a jellyfish, a jellyfish, a jellyfish.
Jellyfish, a jellyfish, a jellyfish, a jellyfish.
Arms up.
Arms up.
Wrists together.
Wrists together.
Elbows together.
Elbows together.
Knees together.
Knees together.
Feet together.
Feet together.
Head back.
Head back.
Tongue out. Okay, now we are going to hear from our clones. They have prepared a special skit for us.
Everybody looks busy, but I think it might be time. I think it's time. Hey, Trillium. Trillium, yeah. Are you there?
Yeah.
Hey, Trillium, is it time yet?
Oh, I don't know. Let me check.
Okay, thanks.
Hey, forgive me not. Is it time yet?
Oh, I don't know. Let me check. Is it time yet?
I don't know. Let me check.
Is it time yet?
I don't know. I'll find out. Is it time yet?
I don't know. Is it time yet?
I'll find out. Is it time yet?
Nope, not time yet.
Not time yet.
Oh, not time yet.
Oh, it's still not time. It's not time yet.
Oh, okay. It's not time yet.
Nope, not yet.
Oh, not yet? Okay. It's not time yet.
It's not time yet? Okay, thanks for checking. Guess I'll sit tight. I really wish it were time already. Okay, how about now? It's gotta be time now. Is it time yet?
I'll check. Let's check. Is it time yet?
Is it time?
I don't know. Let me check.
Is it time?
Oh, is it time yet?
Let me check. Is it time yet?
I don't know. I'll check. Is it time yet?
Let me check. Nope, not time yet.
Not yet.
Oh, it's not yet.
Still, it's not time yet.
Really? It's not time yet.
Not yet.
Oh, you're kidding. It's not time yet.
Oh, really, it's not time yet?
No.
Okay, all right. I'm getting pretty antsy. Okay, how about now? Is it time yet? Please, is it time yet?
I'll check, I'll check.
Thank you.
Is it time yet?
Let me check. Is it time now?
I don't know. I will check. Is it time?
I'll find out. Is it time yet?
Let me check. Is it time yet?
I don't know, I'll check. Is it time yet?
Let me check. It is time!
It's time!
It's time!
It's time! It's time!
It's time! It's time! It's time! It's time!
It's totally time?
Did she say it was time? It's time!
Is it really time? Okay.
It's time! It's time! It's time.
All right, you know what it means? It's time. So, oh yeah. Ah, yes. Welcome to outdoor school.
Thank you.
Woo.
I am time.
Without further ado, Mama Llama, I think Forget-Me-Not's up next. Does she have a special song too?
She does.
Ew. Let's do another repeat after me song. And this time I've recruited my lovely neighbors, Delaney and McCoy and Jack. And they're here to help me. This is a... And Gunner. This is a repeat after... This is a repeat after me song.
This is a repeat after me song.
And a do as I do song.
And a do as I do song.
Here we go. The other day.
The other day.
I met a bear.
I'm a bear.
A great big bear. In tennis shoes. And then we all sing it together. The other day.
I met a bear.
great big bear in Conestoga. He said to me, why don't you run?
Why don't you run?
Because I see you ain't.
I see you ain't got any gun.
He said to me,
why don't you run?
Because I don't got any gun. So I ran. Away from there. But right behind.
Me was that bear.
And so I ran away from there. Right behind me was that bear. And then I saw a great big tree.
A great big tree way out there.
In front of me.
And then I saw a great big tree way out there in front of me.
The nearest branch was 10 feet up. I'd have to jump. And trust my luck. The nearest branch was 10 feet up. I have to jump and trust my luck. And so I jumped. Into the air. But I missed that branch. Away up there.
And so I jumped into the air.
But I missed that branch away up there. Now don't you fret. And don't you frown.
Because I caught that branch.
On the way back down.
Now don't you fret. Because I caught that branch on the way back down.
The moral of the story is.
Don't talk to bears.
In tennis shoes.
The moral of the story is.
Don't talk to bears in tennis shoes.
Awesome.
Wait a second. I have to say something. This is late breaking news, and honestly, nobody here knows this yet. I just got a text. I can't even believe I'm saying this. As seventh graders next year, you guys are gonna get to go to outdoor school next year. We're gonna make it happen. Seriously, I just got the text. I didn't even know it. None of the other clones even know it. You're gonna get to go. Yeah, we're gonna make it happen.
That's awesome.
I know. So I wanted to share that with you right in the middle of our lovely night that we're having tonight. And now I'm actually going to send this to Sasquatcho, and he's gonna actually start the part of our campfire where we bring it down a notch. So instead of cheering really, really loud, we're gonna practice our level two appreciation, which is either the little hands or the sort of wiggly fingers that reflect the light. And he's going to begin with a Native American legend. So it's all yours, Sasquatcho.
Hey, thank you. All right, so yeah, we know no campfire is really complete without a story, either a scary ghost story or an ancient legend. So tonight, everyone sees that title up there, The Search for the Strongest, a Campfire Legend, right? Everybody can see that?
Yes.
Right, so this story is an ancient Native American legend, but funnily enough, the same kind of story is told in India and in Japan. So it's one of those legends that almost every culture in this world sort of came up with on their own. And I think you guys will see why. So here's the story. Once upon a time, there was a mouse family, father mouse, mother mouse, and a little girl mouse. Well, little girl mouse was growing up though. She was becoming an adult, she was ready to get married, and wouldn't you know it, she had fallen in love with a little boy mouse next door. Well, now there's a man mouse. She was in love with him. She said, well, can't I just marry him? Her parents said, let's think. I kind of don't think so. We want our daughter to marry the biggest, toughest, strongest husband in the entire world. So he's out of the picture. He's just a mouse. So of course, the little girl mouse's heart was broken. But her parents said, well, cheer up. We're gonna go out and we are going to go and find you the biggest, strongest, toughest husband in the whole wide world. So off they went. They left their daughter at home and they went off traveling, hiking all over the place until they came across a cat. Hey, buddy, you're bigger than us. You're stronger than every mouse. Why don't you marry our daughter? Because you're the strongest in the whole wide world. The cat said, no, I'm not as strong as the dog, so I'm flattered, but no thank you. So they moved on until they found the biggest dog in the land. They said, dog, please come marry our daughter. You're big and strong. We want the strongest. The dog said, that's a nice offer, but the bear is much stronger than me. And the dog took off. They went off and found the biggest, strongest bear in the whole world. And the bear said, yeah, that's a nice offer. I'd love to marry your daughter, but look up in the sky. You know who's stronger than me? The sun. The sun is the biggest, the brightest. It gives life to everything. Nothing's more powerful than the sun. Go ask the sun to marry your daughter. So off they went, looking for the sun. And wouldn't you know it, they found him. They were hiking along out in the desert. They found the big golden sun up in the sky. They said, Mr. Sun, you're the biggest, strongest. You'd be the greatest husband in the world for our daughter. Would you please come and marry our mouse daughter? The sun said, hey, that's a nice offer. I know I'm big and strong. I bring life to everything. But you know what? When it's too cloudy, the biggest cloud in the world always blocks me out. I'm not stronger than the biggest cloud. Go ask the cloud to marry your daughter. They said, well, maybe that's a good idea. So they went up and they set off to find the biggest cloud in the land. And they climbed a high mountain and they came to the highest peak and they called out, hey, biggest cloud. And the cloud said, what? They said, come marry our daughter. You're the strongest in the whole wide world. And the cloud said, well, that's nice of you to say, but I'm not really the strongest in the whole wide world. I'm just a cloud, and every time the wind blows me away. He's stronger than me. Your daughter should marry the wind. They said, well, you know what? That's the best offer yet. Let's go ask him. They went off to ask the wind. They walked out to an open desert plain where the wind was gusting and blowing. They said, hey, wind. And the wind said, yes. And they said, wind, you got to come marry our daughter because you're the biggest and strongest in the whole wide world. We've been all over. And the wind said, yeah, I'm pretty strong. I can blow the clouds away. But you know what? I can never seem to blow down those brick houses that stand around the village. As hard as I huff and I puff and I storm and I blow, I can never blow the walls down. So you know who's stronger than me? The wall. Go ask your daughter to marry the wall. Mother and father said, that's a little odd, but I guess it couldn't hurt to go talk to the wall. So they went inside, found the biggest building and the biggest wall that they could. They said, hey, Mr. Wall. And the wall said, yeah. They said, Mr. Wall, you're the biggest and strongest in the world. Can you please be our daughter's husband? And the wall said, well, I know that the sun can't get through me and the clouds don't bother me and the wind can't knock me down. But look at the bottom where my feet hit the floor. You see those holes in the bottom of the wall? Do you know who makes those holes? Little mice. They always bite their way and tunnel their way right through me. So you know who I think is the strongest in the whole wide world? Mice. You know who your daughter should marry? A mouse. So mother and father mouse looked at each other and thought for a minute and they said, you know what? I think the answer was right in front of us all along. So they hustled back home and they said to their daughter, all right, go find that wedding dress you picked out. Put it on, you look so great. Let's light all the candles. Let's get our ceremony going. And could you please marry that mouse next door who wants to marry you too? She said, sounds good to me. So they called their friends. They had a big mouse party. And that's sort of the lesson that we learned from this story. Doesn't matter how big, how strong, how bright, how puffy, how hard you huff and puff, and how much noise you make. Sometimes the person, the friend, the someone who you're looking for is right next door. And that story's been around for hundreds of years, and it's still pretty much true today. Without further ado, we're starting to come to the end of our campfire. We're normally clones. Do you remember, what does every good campfire end with, especially after the story? Usually we all get together and what do?
We sing.
I think we sing a song, don't we? But there's one more special something.
Sang out of tune, would you stand up and walk out on me? happy by the end of the day. I'm sad because you're on your own. No, I get by with a little help from my friends. Try with a little help from my friends. Do you need anybody?
I need somebody to love.
Could it be anybody?
I want somebody to love.
Oh, I get by with a little help from my friends. I get by with a little help from my friends.
Try with a little help from my friends. Way to go, Conestoga. Have a great summer. Everybody look at Beetle's screen. What's he got there?
Gonna miss you.
We're gonna miss you a lot. Thumbs up if you miss you Mr. Clayman.
Prize.
But congratulations.
Congratulations.
You guys are great.
Way to go, Beetle.
Woo!
Please come back and sub.
Please be our substitute teacher next year. Be our substitute next year, please.
Thank you, everybody. This was such a wonderful night. We're so glad all you kids could show up. We really miss you, and we hope you have a fantastic summer.
Way to go, sixth grade teachers.
Have a great summer.
Well done.
Nice.
Hi, everyone.
Go ahead, check Canvas. Bye. You can all sign out.
Good night.
Good night, everybody.
Night, everybody.